enthalpy or delta H. This is still on the first part of this chapter. We learn about thermochemistry, that is a branch of chemistry that describes the energy changes that occur during chemical reactions. And I said to you last video that the main energy that involved in chemical reaction is heat. So in this video, we're gonna find out what is the heat of reaction. From previous video, the energy change of reaction can be in the form of heat and work, and we focus on the pressure volume work, which is negative pressure times the change in volume. So if we substitute this into the delta U equation, we're gonna get this equation. Change of internal energy of system is equal to Q plus this pressure volume work. We can rearrange this equation to get the value of Q, and we're gonna get this. So Q or heat is equal to the internal energy change of system and work. For most chemical reaction, we do reaction under a constant pressure. So if we look at the constant pressure condition, this Q will become QP, indicate the constant pressure condition. And this QP is given a new name as delta H or enthalpy change, and it's equal to the change of internal energy of system plus work. And this is called the heat of reaction or enthalpy change of reaction. The important thing about enthalpy now is that it is a state function. So enthalpy change depends only on the initial state and final state of system, which means it depends only on the type of reactants and product in your chemical reaction. If you look at the chemical reaction that have the same reactants and the same product, the enthalpy change must be the same regardless of how many steps would take it to that final reaction. And this is the concept of Hess's law. We're gonna look at that later in this video. Now look at the sign of enthalpy change. Enthalpy change is the heat of reaction. So we have two directions of heat changes. One is called the exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction is a reaction that heat is released from the system to the surroundings. And in this case, the enthalpy change will have a negative sign. Another type of reaction is called the endothermic reaction. In this kind of reaction, the heat is absorbed by the system, and the delta H gonna have a positive sign. You must give the correct sign for the enthalpy change in relation to the type of reaction. Exothermic reaction, delta H is negative. Endothermic reaction, delta H is positive. Now look at how do we calculate the heat of reaction. We start with the calorimetry concept. This is how we get the heat of reaction by measuring the temperature change or delta T and convert this to heat of reaction using the concept of heat capacity. Heat is related to the change of temperature. Depends on the type of substance. Another word, depend on the value of this heat capacity. The given amount of heat can change the temperature differently. High amount of heat would give the high value of change in temperature. However, it depends on the heat capacity of substance as well. So we change this relationship into mathematics equation. using heat capacity or the specific heat in these two equations. The first equation, heat is equal to heat capacity times delta T. The heat capacity here is the amount of heat required to change temperature of a substance by 1 Kelvin. So we don't care about the mass unit of substance, where if you use this equation Q equal to mc delta T, we take into account the amount of substance. M refer to mass of substance, and C, the small letter c here, means specific heat capacity, or we can call it in short as specific heat. This is the amount of heat required to change the temperature of 1 gram of substance by 1 Kelvin. So on this side, doesn't take the mass. On this side, you have to show how much of the substance. These two equations show you that depends on the substance. If you give the same amount of heat, the temperature may change differently. A substance that has low heat capacity value will change temperature much more than the substance that has high heat capacity value. And water is a one substance that has a very high specific heat. It is good to remember this value. For water, the specific heat is equal to 4.184 joule per gram degree Celsius. Why do I change from Kelvin to degree Celsius here? Take a note here. Delta T, we're looking at different in the temperature. And this Kelvin unit and degree Celsius unit has exactly the same different in temperature. So the unit of specific heat can be joule per gram Kelvin or joule per gram degree Celsius. For the actual measurement, we use the calorimeter to find out the heat transfer between our reaction or system and its surrounding. This is a diagram of the simple constant pressure calorimeter. It can be used to measure the heat effects of variety of reaction. Give Q reaction or QP, and this is the enthalpy change. We will let the reaction occur in the calorimeter, and any heat change from the reaction would be transferred to its surrounding or the solution that we use. From the first law of thermodynamics from last video, any change of energy or heat in the system would be equal to the heat change of surrounding, but in the opposite direction. If our system is the chemical reaction that we are interested in, the Q that is occur in the reaction would be equal to the Q that is change of the solution in the opposite direction. Therefore, we can calculate the heat of reaction from the temperature change of the solution like this. Delta T is calculated from T final minus T initial. You have to be careful about this, because then you can indicate the reaction to be either endothermic reaction or exothermic reaction. From the side of enthalpy change, exothermic reaction will have delta H in a negative sign. If you do calorimetry, your heat of reaction is equal to minus mc delta T of solution. This means for the exothermic reaction, heat is released to surrounding. Temperature change of the solution would be positive. That means the temperature of the solution is increased. Temperature of the solution is increased, delta T is positive. That gives you delta H of reaction in a negative value. and it indicates exothermic reaction. Same thing, if we look at the endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed by a system, which means that temperature of solution would be decreases, and that delta T of solution would be a negative value. Put this in here, this is negative, and you have negative sign in front. It means that your delta H of reaction would be in a positive sign, and that refers to the endothermic reaction correctly. So when you do calculation, be careful about getting the temperature change value, and don't forget this negative sign in front, because we look at the reaction by measuring the change of surrounding. Now that you know the value of heat of reaction, put that together with the chemical equation, we get what we call a thermochemical equation. Thermochemical equation, chemical equation that show what is the heat involved. So enthalpy is an extensive property, therefore it depends on the amount of substance used in your reaction. This thermochemical equation is used to show how much enthalpy change for a certain amount of substance. So if you write your chemical equation like this, 1 mole of solid water change into 1 mole of liquid water, and delta H of this reaction is equal to 6.01 kilojoule. You can say that 1 mole of solid water or ice must absorb 6.01 kilojoule of heat to change into 1 mole of liquid water. Working with thermochemical equation, the physical state of all reactants and products are important, because look at these two examples here. The first reaction is the change from solid into liquid, and it has enthalpy change equal to 12.02 kilojoule, where the second equation, liquid change into gas, same amount of mole, but enthalpy change is a lot higher, 88 kilojoule. So state of matter in your reaction are important, as well as the stoichiometry coefficients are also important. From the previous two slides, you already seen that for 1 mole of solid water change to 1 mole of liquid water, you only need delta H of 6.01 kilojoule, but if you double amount of substance in the second equation, you also double the amount of enthalpy change as well. So if you multiply any number into your equation, you must multiply it to your enthalpy change as well. Also, the direction of change is important. The first equation here, solid change into liquid, this is the endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction, solid water must absorb some heat to change into liquid water. If you change the direction of this reaction to be liquid water change into solid water, the liquid water must release heat to change into the solid water, so the reaction become exothermic, and we show it by a negative sign in front of this value. Same number of mole, same physical state, just different direction. We get same number of delta H, but opposite sign. One direction is endothermic, the opposite direction what must be exothermic. Once we know the thermochemical equation, we can apply stoichiometry to the heat of reaction as well. The quantity of heat obtained from a reaction will depend on the amount of reactants or products produced. So, use the stoichiometry concept to calculate the amount of heat involved. From this equation, combustion reaction of methane gas produce carbon dioxide and water. In this reaction, one mole of methane react to two mole of oxygen, produce one mole carbon dioxide and two moles of liquid water. The enthalpy change is negative 890.3 kilojoule. When you see a reaction like this, the first thing first, you can say that this reaction is an exothermic reaction because of a negative sign of delta H. You can also say that one mole of methane is used. The amount of heat generated or released is 890.3 kilojoule. If you use only half amount of methane from 1 mole to 0.5 mole, the heat that is released or obtained or generated would be half of the 890.3 kilojoule. So you multiply 0.5 to the amount of enthalpy change. Or you can say that if you obtain 890.3 kilojoule of heat, you can obtain one mole of carbon dioxide. So the amount of substance is related to the amount of heat involved. What else can we say about this reaction? Same thing, if you produce two mole of liquid water, the heat generated or released is also 890.3 kilojoule. Think about if you produce only half amount of water, what is the heat released? There are so many exercises for this kind of stoichiometry calculation, นะคะ practice on those, นะคะ Move on to the next way to calculate the heat of reaction.This is the Hess's law concept. The Hess's law concept is about the summation of heat of reaction. This used because of the fact that the enthalpy change is the state function. Therefore, the enthalpy change of an overall process is the sum of the enthalpy changes of its individual step. Here is the example of enthalpy diagram illustrating Hess's law.We have initial state here, reactants. We have two mole of graphite and two mole of oxygen. This reactant will change to product here, our final state. Product consists of two mole of carbon monoxide and one mole of oxygen. To change from reactants to product, in this slide, we have two parts. Number one consists of two steps, step one and step two.Step 1, reactant change into this intermediate of reaction first, and this is the exothermic reaction because delta H is in the negative value. And this intermediate reaction absorbs energy and produces this product. The second step, or step number 2 here, is endothermic reaction because delta H is in a positive value.Or the reactants can change directly into product in just one step in step indicated by number 3 here. This is the exothermic reaction. Delta H3 is negative 221.0 kilojoule. Hess's law concept show that for reactants to change into productsFor reactants to change to products, the energy change or enthalpy change must be just one value, regardless of how the change occurs. So the two steps must produce the total energy change equal to the one step. So prove that delta H of the two steps is delta H1 plus delta H2, and that make negative 221.0 kilojoule. And this is the same value as in the one-step process, negative 221.0 kilojoule. So delta H3 is equal to delta H1 plus delta H2. The Hess's law concept can be used to find out the heat of reaction that cannot be measured experimentally. In this slide, reaction number 3 here, sulfur react to oxygen and produce sulfur trioxide. This reaction cannot be measure the heat involved very easily. However, we can get the enthalpy change of this reaction by looking at reaction number 1 and reaction number 2. Is there any way that we can add these two together and make it exactly the same as reaction number 3? The answer is yes. In reaction number 3, we want sulfur. Where is it? Is it in reaction number 1? So here, this is what we want. Okay. Another thing that can be seen over here is that we have this sulfur trioxide. However, what we want is only one mole. In this second reaction, it has two mole. We can make it the same by multiply reaction number 2 by half. And when we do that, we have to multiply the number to the enthalpy change as well. So this is what we got. When reaction number 2 is multiplied by half, we get 1 mole of sulfur dioxide, half the mole of oxygen, and 1 mole of sulfur trioxide. So right now, we can make the summation of these two reactions, and it's going to look like this reaction exactly. We have sulfur here. We have oxygen, 1 plus half become 3 half. And the sulfur dioxide here is in opposite of the arrow, so it's cancelled away. And this is here. So, summation of reaction, the enthalpy change get to be add up as well. So delta H3 is equal to this amount plus this amount. So this is the application of Hess's law. Last thing that we can use to calculate the heat of reaction is by using what is called a standard heat of formation. And we use this symbol delta H subscript F superscript 0. This standard heat of formation is the enthalpy change of the formation reaction when all the substances are in their standard thermodynamic conditions. We can make lists of enthalpy change from the Hess's law concept. Hess's law relates the enthalpy change of some reaction to the enthalpy change of others. So we only need to tabulate or make the list of enthalpy change of a certain type of reaction. And we can do this by using the standard thermodynamic condition, which refer to the pressure of 1 atm and a specified temperature. Usually, we use the temperature 25 degrees Celsius. And when we talk about the standard condition, we indicate that variable by a superscript degree sign or superscript 0. This is the example of formation reaction. Formation reaction of any substance is the chemical reaction that produces one mole of that substance, produce one mole of that substance, so it's product here, from the element in the most thermodynamic stable state. So methane consists of carbon and hydrogen. The most stable state of carbon is carbon graphite. The most stable state of hydrogen is the diatomic gas here. And this is the formation reaction of methane. The heat involved in this reaction is the standard heat of formation, and that equal to negative 74.9 kilojoule. This is an exothermic reaction. Same thing for methanol and sodium chloride here. This is the example of the table that gives you the standard heats of formation of various substances. The heat of formation can be exothermic, it can be endothermic, and some of those are given the value 0, like this one for calcium. Calcium in a solid state has delta H of formation as 0, and you see that graphite is the most stable state, and that has the delta H of formation equal to 0. So the most stable state of the element are given the standard heat of formation equal to 0. So you can see it here. I have given you a document that show a full list of delta H of formation of various substance. You can check that out. And we get to use the standard heat of formation to find out the heat of reaction by this relationship. The heat of reaction is equal to the summation of heat of formation of product minus the summation of heat of formation of reactants. Of course, you have to multiply heat of formation with the stoichiometry coefficient first. This symbol is the summation sign. So if you have more than one product, you're gonna add the heat of formation all up, and then the reactants also. If you have more than one reactants, you're gonna add them all up and then subtract that from the product. You can get the heat of reaction. This is an example on how do you use the equation. The question asks you to use the standard heat of formation. Calculate the heat of combustion of the following reaction. So this is the heat of reaction anyway. This substance reacts to oxygen, produce carbon dioxide and water. What do we need is the equation like this. Use the standard heat of formation, and that's related to the heat of reaction by this formula. So the next thing is you're gonna find out the value of heat of formation of each substance. You're gonna go to the standard variable, and check the delta H of formation of this substance. And these are the value of delta H of formation of each substance. Remember to take the sign with it, check this negative value and put the correct number down. When you know this, you can put them into this equation. Or another way you can do it is by make the calculation with the stoichiometry like this. This is 1. 1 times this value give the same value. This is 3 times 0. This is 2 multiply with this value give you this number. And the same thing for water, 2 mole multiply with this number give you this value. And this is the product side and this is the reactant side. Add these two together, you get this value. Add these two together, you get this value. Now you get the summation of the heat of formation on the product side and on the reactant side. You can calculate the heat of reaction like this. The summation of heat of formation of the product minus the summation of heat of formation on the reactant, and this is your final answer. The calculation is not very difficult, but sometimes you just forgot about the sign here, and most of the time when you get the wrong result, it is from when you get the value here, you don't check the number correctly. When you use your calculator, it's given you the wrong answer. So you must be careful about those things. Bring us to the end of this video. The summary on this video is that what we learn about the meaning of enthalpy change. This is the heat of reaction under a constant pressure. The direction of heat change can be in two ways. One is endothermic reaction, delta H is given a positive sign. Exothermic reaction, delta H is given a negative sign. We can calculate the heat of reaction by calorimetry method, and that is the relationship of heat and temperature change by the concept of the specific heat. We can use Hess's law if we know that the reaction of interest is made up from different steps. We can add all the steps together, and then the enthalpy change are also added together. And we can also use the heat of formation to calculate heat of reaction by using this relationship. Okay, ค่ะ. I see you again next video. สวัสดีนะคะ.